What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you subscribe, and if you find this video helpful, make sure to leave me a like so I'll know to keep posting more content. In this video, we will be talking about two different functions. The first will be the line to polygon, and then the second will be the polygon to line functions. So let's start with the line to polygon. I brought in two layers here. We'll start with the line layer. Boom. All right, so we will call this a new language. No, I'm kidding. These are just random scratches that I put on here, just random lines. So what we want to do is make these lines into polygons. And the function that I'm going to use, the line to polygon, is going to give us a estimated polygon for the line in our canvas. Now, I'll show you how to get to the function. We'll go up here to Vector, Geometry Tools, Lines to Polygons. Okay, it's going to bring up this dialog box, and it's going to give you pretty much one main option, the input layer. Okay, so you're going to choose your input layer that you want to use here, and you can select the features or whatever, but for the purpose and the time of this video, I'm just going to run this function on all of these lines at once. So let's do it. We'll run this. Boom. And we'll see that there are polygons now, and we have a new layer over here, a scratch layer. You know this is a scratch layer because of this little symbol out here of polygons, okay? So when we think of polygons, we always think of features where the starting point and the end point are the same, okay? So when we count these polygons, how many polygons do you see? The start and the end point have to be the same. So let's see. One, let's say this is a start. It goes all the way around and comes back to its end point. That is a polygon. Same here. Start here, boom, boom, back around. Okay, same here. So we see that same pattern in all of the polygons. So when we count how many polygons we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, but let me show you guys something. If you go to the attribute table for polygons, or the new scratch layer polygons we just created, look what we see. We see four features here, four features. And why is that? Okay, well, the reason is this function does not create new polygons, okay? This function is only going to use the number of features that you enter into it. So our initial feature count, if we go back, we deselect polygons, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so whatever the number of features that you enter, that is what will be in the attribute table. Okay, so that is our lines to polygons. Now, let's use the polygon to line. And let me show you one quick thing. If you ever get an error about this, let me show you real quick. Polygons and lines. I'm going to go ahead and go to the function. Let's go to vector. Or first of all, let me take lines down, and let me take polygon down, and I'll just bring up our polygons. These are my polygons I want to use for the polygon to line feature, and then I'll show you guys that error at the end. Okay, so we're going to go up here to Vector, Geometry Tools, Polygons to Lines. Okay, now what you want to make sure is that you select your right layer, PL1, Polygon Layer 1, and I'm going to run this. Okay, so now I get this new scratch layer created called lines. Okay, so if I deselect my polygons, then you will see that these lines are here. Now, how do you tell the difference between lines and polygons? Remember, in a previous video, I showed you guys about the vertex tool. The vertex tool, when you're working with polygons, will move the entire polygon or transfigure the entire polygon. But when you're working with lines in the vertex tool, you can move the individual vertexes around each other. Okay, so let me show you guys what I'm talking about. In the line layer, I go into edit mode and I go right here to my vertex tool, and I'll just work in this layer, the current layer. And now I'll come in and you see my cursor changes to crosshairs. And when I come in and I zoom over one of these, what looks like a polygon, if I move one of these vertexes, watch what happens. Boom. Am I in the right layer? Polygon, line layer, because it's moving the whole thing. Okay. Let's do this. We'll exit edit mode. Save. Exit edit mode here. Save. All right, now. Let's try this again. We'll go with our vertex. Should be able to. There we are. Okay. So now you see that I had to go in. I had to turn off the edit mode for my other two layers. And now you can see that I can control individual lines to do exactly what I want them to do. The other thing that I wanted to show you guys was that error that I was talking about earlier. So let's say if I go back to my polygons, I can close the line. And like I said before, in the attribute table, we only have four features here. So if we try to use the polygon to line function here, watch what happens. I'll open up the dialog box real quick. Polygons to lines. And let's go ahead and put in that scratch layer, polygons. And watch what happens when I try to run this. Run, it's going to give me an error. Feature 1 has invalid geometry. Please fix the geometry or change the processing setting to the ignore invalid input features option. Okay, so you don't have to do this. The reason that it did this is, like I said before, there are 6 true polygons here, but only 4 in the attribute table. That's the only thing that's causing that problem. Okay, so if you run into this error, don't worry about it. You can't, if you know what you're doing, you can go into settings and say ignore invalid input features, but the error will not be changed. Your features will still be in error. What you can do to solve this, you can use I did a video on the clip function. And you can clip a feature out of, so like say if I have this little triangle here, I can clip right through here and have 2 separate features. Or I can clip here. Or you can, I mean, there are several features that you can use to fix that problem. But anyway, if you have any questions, any comments, leave them in the comments section. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.